Hello students, let's discuss about shortest path. The shortest path is one of the Dijkstra algorithm which used to find out the shortest path between vertices in the edge over the vertex weighted graph. That means particularly we are starting from one vertex and to find a desired our destination vertex where the minimum path will be represented. That means here we are finding the shortest path from start to the desired vertex in a graph. So basic idea about this shortest path algorithm is based on the somewhat similar to the minimum spanning tree. Here we are going to add exactly one vertex to the tree of vertex for which we know the shortest path. Yes. Now we'll see one example. We have a graph which having a 5 vertex and the edge which are labeled with some of the values, that is weighted edge are represented or connected within the vertex. Now if I want to find out the shortest path within this graph, so first of all I have to create the table, and the first row I should mention the vertex 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Where the first column, I will mention the vertex number where I have visited. So first, I will consider here, I am going to start from the vertex 1 to the vertex 5. So initially, we don't have edged or weighted vertex. So initially, we will consider all the vertex weight will be infinite. Now we are starting with the first node or the first vertex. So first vertex to the first, obviously it will going to be represented as a 0. So from first vertex to the second, the edge is labeled with 4. So the value is going to be represented here is 4. And from first vertex to the third, I should start from 1, 2nd and 3rd. So directly I am not reaching to the 3rd. I should go from 2nd to 3rd. But still 2nd has not been visited. So it will be considered as a infinite. Now next, for 1st to the 4th, I can either go from 1st to 2nd, 2nd to 3rd and 3rd to 4th, but still we are not visited 2nd and 3rd, we are only at 1. So from 1 to 4 I can directly get the edge related with weight is 8, so I will put 8 over there. And for 5, edge 5 from 1, again we are not having visited to the 4, so it will be again infinite. Now we'll go with the second. So first and second. So from to visit at first, so second to the first, first is already visited. So whatever the value we are having for first, I will put as it is. And for second, first to the second, so what value I am getting, I should start from 1. So 1 to 2. Value I am getting here, the weighted is 4, so I will represent the 4. So from 4, from 1 to 3, I have visited first and second, so I will come from 1, 2, 3. So the count will be, value will be 4 plus 3, it is 7. So I should put 7 because 2 and 1 I have already visited. Now to the 4th, so to the 4th is, the value I am getting it from 1, 2, 3, and to the 4. So what value I am getting here is 8, as it is going to be, I am getting from 1 to 4, because I am not, still I have not visited the 3, so I will not go from 4, 3, 4. So now next, for the 5th, it will have been 18. Now next, if I go with the node 3, so the first value I am getting here to the first node is 0. Similarly for second 4, for third it is 7, for fourth it is 8, and for fifth it is 18. Now for fourth node, again I am getting up to fourth the same value, but if I am going from to the fifth node or the fifth vertex, either I can go from this way, or either I can go from 1, 1, 4 and 5. This will give me the shortest path, that is 8 plus 7, I am getting it is 15. So I will replace this 18 with 15. And the next, the last node, which is the 5th, so what I am getting, the same value it is resulting with the nodes. Wait. So this last row, I will consider the weight which I am getting at every vertex. So 0 I am getting at the one vertex, this 4 I am getting for the second vertex, and 7 I am getting for the third vertex, 8 weight I am getting for the fourth vertex, and 15 I am getting for the fifth vertex. So if I choose to go from 1 to 5, the weight, the shortest path I am getting is 15. Now suppose if I want to go for a 7, the shortest path I am getting it is 1 to 2, 2 to 3. This is the descent algorithm. Okay. Next concept is network flow and bipartite matching. So any edge weighted graphs can be thought of as a network of pipes, whereas the weight of the edge, edge of ij, measure with the capacity of the pipe. So here the capacity in the sense of how much values or how much data is going to be flows across the pipe or across the network. So here the cross section area of the pipe is wide pipe that might be carries a 10 unit of flow in a given time, whereas a narrow pipe might be able to carry only the 5 unit. So the weighted graph G has two vertices S and T, so it's going to be find out the maximum value that will be flow from S to T that represent the maximum capacity of each pipe. So best example is having bipartite or the two collaboral if vertex has divided into the two sets, that is L and R, such that all edges represented in the graph have vertex L and one vertex is R. So all, or we can say the many natural defined graph is R bipartite. Thank you.